Hi, I'm Dave Warzone. You're watching PHTV4, Living Well. And today on Living Well, we're going to take a look at something that's right on the horizon, maybe unfortunately. But on Living Well in general, we take a look at a variety of topics that deal with living a healthy lifestyle, whether it's exercise, nutrition, whatever route we can get there. Mm-hmm. That's what we're going to take a look at. Today, unfortunately, or maybe fortunately, because Carolyn, who is a co-owner of Pass Health Foods in Palos Heights, on College Drive, is going to help us deal with seasonal allergies, we're hoping. Nice weather is around the corner.
Yes.
And unfortunately, sometimes that weather approaching brings allergies with it, the seasonal allergies. So thank you for being here today.
Absolutely.
Let's take a look at first, like, what are some types of products, some types of alternative approaches to the, you know, prescriptive thing that people might do that can help strengthen their body's responses to seasonal allergies?
So seasonal allergies are horrible. Spring allergies, because, and it's caused by pollen, but it's a different pollen than we think about. Usually when we think of pollen, we think of honeybees and flowers and a little bee going from flower to flower with that pollen, but that's not what happens in the spring. And the cause is trees. And I'm a huge tree lover. I hate to blame them, you know, anything on them, but it's tree pollen that is causing spring allergies. And it's because it's really too early for a lot of the pollinators that we're familiar with, like bumblebees and butterflies. So trees all have flowers. We think of flowering trees like a crabapple or a magnolia with these big, beautiful flowers. But every tree has little buds that are opening, and they're wind pollinated. So if you look even now, even in late winter or early spring, maples, I feel like it's especially easy to see. On the branches, you'll see these little balls, and they get bigger and bigger and bigger, and those are the buds that are going to open to release that pollen. And being wind pollinated means that all of these are opening, and their pollen is just spewing out into the air. And so we have pollen just blowing all around. The air is like thick with pollen, and it's breathing that in that is causing that reaction. So for people with spring allergies, it's actually surprising everyone doesn't have a reaction to that, because we're constantly breathing in all of this pollen. And so for people with allergies, your body is actually trying to help you, because it's seeing that pollen as an invader, and it's trying to protect you. So it's producing histamine, it's causing itchy, watery eyes, your sinuses are, you know, your nose is running, it's all congested.
Yeah, unfortunately, those are I'm very familiar with those symptoms.
Yes, those are all symptoms of your body trying its best to protect you against this pollen that it sees as an invader, as something that's going to make you sick. So there are natural things that can make a difference. And the nice thing about natural products is you're usually not getting those negative side effects like you would, like feeling tired or out of it or things like that, that a lot of over-the-counter allergy medications have. So I'd say one of the best things is quercetin. So quercetin is, it's like an antioxidant that's in many fruits and vegetables. And it's great in the winter because it's helping with respiratory infections and things like that. But for allergies, it works really well because it's reducing inflammation in our whole respiratory tract, you know, reducing inflammation in the lungs, but also working with cells called, they're called mast cells. And what they do is those are the cells that are releasing all this histamine in response to the pollen. So it's helping to kind of calm all that down, reducing the amount of histamine that is released. And it's not over drying anything or anything like that, but it's more helping your body to get back to its normal state, calming down that overreaction that it has to the pollen.
Now, you mentioned taking it like in the winter.
Yes. Yeah, I take quercetin even now because I take it for respiratory,
okay,
you know, preventing respiratory infection.
So just to double check on that real quick, let's say somebody's like, one way they can get in front of the symptoms.
Yes.
What happens if, all right, now I'm getting hit by them,
yeah,
and I can jump in with it, I can start taking it while I'm feeling
those
side effects?
You can. So I'd say it is going to work best starting before allergy season starts, like starting now or as soon as possible, you know, the very beginnings of spring, you know, late winter, because even today as we're filming this, there's a little bit of snow, but we are not very far from, you know, all of that. So Kristen is great. There's another product called Stinging Nettle, which is great for allergies. So we actually have a product at Pass Health Foods that it combines it. You probably can't see this, but I think they'll do a Zoom. Mm-hmm. But it's combining that quercetin, which works really well, along with nettle, which also works really well for helping with a variety of allergy symptoms. So taking those together can really help. And you can take it when you're in just the throes of it, like if you haven't taken anything ahead of time. But I'd say you're going to have the best luck taking it, you know, a little bit ahead so that you're kind of getting ready. And then when all that pollen starts, you know, you're...
Let's say you're in the midst of the symptoms that you're talking about and you start taking that. Mm. How long does it take to feel the benefit? Because like an over-the-counter thing, if you
prescriptive,
you're going to get relief very quickly.
So especially this quercetin nettle, you can take it just when you're starting to have all those symptoms. And especially if you take a little bit higher amount of it, it will help, you know, right then. But with anything, you know, I'd say nothing, even something over the counter or even prescriptions are 100% for every single person. Mm-hmm. But there's good research on these, you know, and we do really stand behind that it's something that can really help.
It will mitigate the symptoms. Okay. So here's a couple supplements people can take that might help with that. What about other, you know, whether food products or beverages that can help.
So
part of our diet, I guess.
During allergy season, having more fresh fruits and vegetables, things high in vitamin C, that can make a difference, you know, just for your allergy symptoms. But then also, I'd say the food that is best is local honey. Local, raw, unprocessed, unheated honey. And we have that at the store. I actually brought some, and I brought spoons if we want to try it. But honey for allergies, we have a lot of people that use it and have really good results. But you should start taking it before allergies start. You know, you should start taking it even late winter, early spring. And the idea of it is that these bees have made this honey from our environment, from the flowers and the plants and the trees that are in our area, not, you know, wherever else, you know, you buy honey in the grocery store from wherever, you know, that this is from our area. And the idea is having a spoonful of that a day, especially leading up to allergy season, because this will also, you know, unfiltered, raw, real honey, it's going to have, in addition to just the benefits of honey, you know, enzymes, a lot of health-promoting sort of things, there are little bits of pollen in this as well. So it's almost like you're getting your body ready to be like, okay, let's not freak out, you know, so a lot of people find that helps. And it's nice for kids, because kids often, you know, they're not swallowing pills or doing different things, but we have a lot of people who do it for their kids, you know, their elementary school. You shouldn't give honey to babies under one, but, you know, giving a spoonful of honey to even kids who suffer from allergies, which is horrible. I feel bad for, you know, kids who are having all those allergy symptoms. But we do have a lot of people that use it and feel like it helps. And it's delicious. You know, so even if you aren't having, you know, your allergies fixed, I'd say local honey is a great thing to take. Do you want to try some?
Sure, we can do it. And I was going to say, because I also, you know, eat local honey and I put it on biscuits or tea or sneak it in anywhere I can. It does taste different than some of the processed. Are you going to try it with me?
Yeah.
That it.
This is delicious honey.
Yeah. And it tastes different than what you might think, like a more typically processed or something that's refined.
And the neat thing is, it's different. Since it's such a natural product, it's different each year. You know, like I have an old bottle from last year, and even the color will be different from year to year.
Right.
You know, they do taste a little different just because of what's been blooming or whatever else. But yeah, it's delicious. You know, just even off the spoon.
It is good.
Yeah.
It is good. And it actually, this almost has a fruity taste to it.
They're all different, you know, so.
It doesn't taste like I would have thought of honey like 10 years ago.
Yeah.
And you're right. And I noticed there is seasonal honey that some of it's darker in color, some of it's lighter in color. It's interesting. It's really good.
Yeah, no, I agree.
All right, I won't do it again. I won't take another dip.
No double dipping.
No double dipping. All right. Yeah, that is really good.
Yeah.
And again, like you said, a nice, maybe easier way to help
yes.
your body.
Yes, yeah.
What is the research on honey specifically, why it works or
so,
how it's effective?
So, I mean, I think the idea is just that it's from those plants.
Okay.
You know, and we do have a lot of people who really feel like it helps, you know.
Yeah.
But even if not, I mean, it's
still
nice.
A healthy option.
Yeah, and it's kind of neat having something, just like growing your own vegetables, like kind of connecting you to the environment and things
sure.
like that. It's a neat thing.
Right. Healthier, it is a sweetener, I would imagine, much
yes.
healthier also.
I mean, it's still sugar, so I think sometimes people think like, oh, honey, it's, you know, it is still sugar,
right.
it is still going to impact your blood sugar, so I mean, don't have a whole
yeah, right, the whole jar.
Jar.
All right. Any other products or items you want to recommend to help manage allergies?
Yes. So if all else fails and, you know, you've not taken anything or nothing is helping, even the over-the-counter stuff, there are things that can help and there are lifestyle things that you can do that makes a difference for allergies. So I'd say something to do in allergy season, if you're someone who suffers from seasonal allergies, is try to keep your house as pollen-free as possible. So it's hard because we have these gorgeous spring days and you want to open your
right.
windows and everything. But if you have seasonal allergies, you have spring allergies, try and keep your house as free from pollen as possible, which means keeping your windows closed. Because think, the air is literally thick with pollen. We can't see it, but it's since it's that wind pollinated, it's just everywhere in the air. So every time you breathe in, you're breathing in that pollen. So if your house can be a pollen-free zone as much as possible, that's going to help to give you a break from constantly being assailed by this pollen that's causing these problems. So keeping your windows closed, also keeping on your house fan, like your furnace fan, and replacing your furnace filter. They even have ones that are higher in filtration or like
right.
a HEPA filter or something like that. That can make a difference so that if anything that's come in from outside, cleaning that out of the air. Also taking a when you get home from being outside, changing your clothes and even taking a shower, because pollen is sticky. Think of in the summer and you see these bees that are covered in little grains of pollen. That pollen is sticking to us. It's sticking to our clothes. It's sticking to your hair, especially if you're
furniture,
long-haired,
your
whatever.
Pillows,
yeah.
yeah.
So by having a shower, washing your hair, then when you go to sleep at night, your pillow is not being covered in pollen that you're then breathing all night.
Right,
you know, so really trying to focus on clearing all that out. And something that goes along with that is a neti pot. And it looks strange. It looks like a little teapot. And I actually brought mine. They're really economical because I have had this neti pot for probably 15 years. Mm-hmm. It's ceramic, you can wash it, you can use it for other people, and you know, you're not using it every day. So, but it's fabulous for helping to clear out your sinuses, because your sinuses are more than just your nose. You know, your sinuses, it goes back in here, it's mm-hmm. it's like a whole system. So using a neti pot, it seems strange, but when you use it the first time, like, it really is a great thing. So you're filling it with water. I'd use bottled water. And you're putting a little bit of salt in it, about a quarter teaspoon. I don't really measure it. I'll mix it and I'll taste it, because it should taste salty, almost like how broth or something, but it shouldn't be, like, so salty. You're trying to make your own saline solution. And the way you use a neti pot, so you're filling it with water and a little bit of salt. It shouldn't be ice cold, you know, like room temperature is good. And you want to do this in the bathroom over the sink. And you're putting it in one nostril, and then it's going in that nostril, you're tilting your head, so it's going down into your sinuses and then out your other nostril. It looks crazy, but it really works. And people are afraid, they're like, oh my gosh, I don't want to get water down my throat. It won't. If you're doing this, like I'm sitting up right now, if you were to do this sitting up like this, yeah, you probably would. But you're leaning over your sink and you're tilting your head, so your nose is actually lower than your throat, so
okay.
there's no way it can go down.
Right.
But you're putting it in your nostril, This is, I mean, it's not full of water, we're going to pretend. But it's going into your sinuses and it's going to run out your other nostril. And you're doing this like this in front of your sink. And it works great. And then, you do it, maybe half the thing, blow your nose, get all that water out, and it's going to clear out excess mucus, any pollen, pollution, whatever is around. So it works really well for allergies because you're just clearing all that junk out. You're starting fresh, especially before bed or if you've been outside. It's a fabulous thing. And it's even good for like colds or any kind of thing where you're congested because just clearing all that out. There are other ones too, like some people are nervous about a neti pot, but I feel like it's the easiest thing. But they sell ones that are like these. We have these at the store where you fill it with water and it's almost like a squirt bottle. So it's nice for kids because they can kind of squeeze it and do it themselves if you think that this would be too difficult. But I really feel like the regular teapot looking one is the most gentle and the easiest to use because it's just like gravity that's putting it through. But it works really well. And once you have this, you can reuse it, indefinitely because it's ceramic. You can put it in the dishwasher. Other people in your family can use it. But it works really well for just getting that pollen out until we're done with allergy season.
How often are you doing that? Is it once a day?
Yeah, once a day. Right. I mean, you can do it as often as you want. If you feel like you have, congestion or whatever, and it's also moisturizing your sinuses, which is nice. But so you can do it as often as you want, but most people during allergy season would do it once a day. They do it after they got home from work or being outside or before bed. You don't need to be doing it every, 5 minutes.
Right. Okay. All right. It's an interesting option. I wasn't even aware of that one. I don't know if it tastes as good as the honey, but it still sounds
good. But it's easy and it's nothing. You're not putting anything in your body, if you're worried about whatever else, but it's such an easy thing. Right. And it seems weird, but when you do it the first time, you're like, oh, this is great, actually. So I would definitely recommend it.
Okay. Carolyn, thank you very much.
Yes.
Several good options for people dealing with allergies. We're headed into that season and some great ways to take it on, right? Help your body deal with it. Thanks again for being here this morning. I'm Dave Wurzel, and you've been watching Living Well. We've been talking with Carolyn Johnson, co-owner at Pass Health Foods in Palos Heights. Thank you for watching, and be healthy.